you feel that skin contact, you'll enter the hypnotic sleep. Closer and closer, very, very close. Closer and closer. And deep sleep.
Came to understand what some of those emotions through the imagery work were about, and I can quickly release a body syndrome like that.
You have a shield up in the mind and a shield up in the body, because that's the critical faculty that stops things from coming in, new ideas from coming in.
It's going to be so much easier just to close your eyes and to let it go. And heavier, and heavier, and heavier, and heavier. And eyes closed, deep sleep.
That's a defense mechanism. It is meant to protect our ego. It is meant to help us reframe. It is a good thing, not a bad thing.
How do you change your behavior? How do you change your communication to help them get into a different state of mind? All of us, I'm sure, have some skill set where we know how to do that naturally, intuitively. We probably never even thought about it that way. But we all have this ability to be evocative, to help a person get into a different state.
Yes, we can create new neural pathways in the brain, and we can adjust the old ones. It's habit replacement.
And I ask the client to focus on the middle finger. And in a moment, when I release your hand and arm, the fingers will begin separating. And on the word separating, I let go.
The way you think about life, it's the way you think about men, it's the way you think about women, it's the way you think about success and money and prosperity and relationships. All of those things have become automatic.
So it's an overload of message units, disorganizing the inhibitory process of critical mind, triggering fight flight, leads to hypersuggestibility and access to the subconscious mind.